Well, hello, it's Thursday. And I did say I might do a tidy up Thursday. And I have a few minutes before I head off to a book club meeting. We read The Sugar Queen this time, and I'm looking forward to diving into the conversation around that. Speaking of which, I love to read. And by the way, before I continue, let me just say I'm Joan Silva. And the way you can reach me is via Facebook, Joan Silva, or my website, joansilva.com. And I do have a contact page, so please feel free. If you want to talk further about tidying in any fashion, do let me know. But let's get back to books. I'm going to make this fairly short and fairly quick. I love books, and many of us do. Many of us still like the physical book, you know, the touching of the physical book. You open it and it just feels, it breathes, it speaks to you. It has texture, it has energy. And many of us, because we were raised reading books and not having a digital platform, love to have our books. And of course, I do both. I do both digital and I do regular books. However, either one can get rather cluttered. And we can end up with our shelves just lined with book after book. And before we know, we have to put them on top. And sometimes we have to squeeze them in, make piles next to the chair, on our bedside table. And I am one of these that loves to read a couple books at once. I will have a self-help or a how-to book along with a novel. And then sometimes a more serious storyline. I am in a movie lovers book club where there's books that they made into movies, and I'm also in a regular book club, both of which, of course, pick different books to read. So you can imagine how many books I may accumulate. By the way, I'm an avid reader, have been since a very young age. I should say not that young, early teens. My family were not big readers, so what we ended up doing is other things, lots of travel and so forth, busy family. So what do you do about books? I'm going to tell you what my husband and I did. We had a table out in the garage, several, and we took one whole room of books. Now, I'm really good at organizing and making everything look quite snazzy or hidden. You know, I can get things hidden. I have cabinets and closets, things like that. You can put your books in. So I had way more books than I thought. So we, instead of having every single book in the house, which is the tidying up approach, is to take every book. When you're doing books, this is done in other areas too, but it's area, the things, the stuff. So we took every book out of, let's say, our offices one at a time. So we have two offices because we're both self-employed. We have our bedroom. We have the living room and family room. I'm right now sitting in our dining room with my kitchen behind me. You see my little elephants hanging there. I'm an elephant lover. And so we took just one room's worth of books and put them on the table and touched every single one and said, and had bags already prepared. This bag would go to, let's just say, the hospital. This bag would go to Goodwill. This bag would go to our bookstore that we have local here that takes used books. This would go to the library. And then there were books that just simply would be tossed. It breaks your heart to do that because somebody wrote it and it had value. And we each touched them. So, you know, was this something I found useful, joyful? And here's the key. It doesn't matter if you read the book or not. Because quite often it's just because you bought it. That was all you needed. And if it's still sitting on the shelf, not honored in a way that books are meant to be, then it's time to let it move on. That's the hardest part because you'll think, oh, well, I'll read this someday. Well, how many some days? And the idea is to bring your library down to a more doable amount. And that, according to the tidying up approach, is like 30 to 50 books. And that's pretty difficult for us people who love our books, especially when you have business books like I do and personal books as I do, and then my husband does too. So let's just say that we did do this, and we did it room by room. And once we did room by room, we set aside those in the one room. We brought the next room down. We did not put them away. So here's the concept. You don't organize till you tidy up. You purge, you release. So we took them in our trunk and drove to the various places and let go of the books. Then we organized. In other words, then we then said, okay, which bookshelves? And amazingly enough, we had many empty open shelves. Many cabinets where I had stuffed books no longer had books in them. So today, that's it. It's Tidy Up Thursday, and it's about books. One of the areas that I found particularly challenging, my husband always said that was my clutter. And I'm the kind of person that likes everything neat and tidy. I might hide it. I might put it behind a cabinet. I might call it a vignette of tchotchkes that are decorative, whatever. Joan Silva, your Tidy Up gal, on Tidy Up Thursday. And enjoy your day. You want to get in touch? JoanSilva.com.